crazy being here like not on game day. And it's just like
dead.
I know.
People are just looking at us like we're weird.
We are weird. So we're currently here, Qualcomm. It's Saturday, December 17th. In about a month, on January 15th, is when we'll know, big stadium decision, whether or not the Chargers are gonna stay here in San Diego or if they're gonna relocate to LA. My name is Derek Huerta, and this is my girlfriend, Tanya. Together, we've shared countless experiences and made many memories attending Charger games and rooting for our team. In fact, the first day we met, we hung out at Chargers minicamp back in 2008. Ever since I could remember, I've been a Chargers fan. I owe a lot of that to my dad, who's been a long-time Chargers fan and season ticket holder. In fact, the older I got, I just ended up going to the games more and more. Tanya also grew up a Chargers fan, and she owes a lot of that to her sister, Tree, who was a major big-time Chargers fan. I mean, we're talking practices, training camp, special events, you name it, she attended it all. And Tanya was there, along for the ride most of the time. As the years have gone on, all we've done is made more and more memories. We've attended fan fests, participated in the Bolt to the Queue 5K twice, and we've both experienced many memories at Qualcomm Stadium, or Jack Murphy Field, depending on who you ask. In our opinion, we really wish the Chargers would stay in San Diego. That's where we feel where they belong, to be honest. I know in some instances, moving to LA might make sense financially or from a business standpoint, but from a fan standpoint, we really don't want to see our team go. So we're here, pre-game, tailgating once again. It feels a little bit different, and I know the circumstances are the circumstances, and that's probably why. It also could be because it's New Year's Day, and a lot of people are probably still sleeping in and hungover. But there's a very different feeling. There's not like the typical energetic feeling or buzz in the air. I mean, just look behind me. There's like a lot of emptiness in the parking lot. Not really sure how that's gonna play out, but we'll see how the day goes.
We have two beautiful footballs here that were donated by the Chargers, so we could do this today. One is an autographed football, Melvin Gordon football. The other one is a commemorative future Hall of Famer LT football. We're gonna go around with my bros, they're gonna help me out. $5 gets you one ticket, $10 gets you three. I'm asking the Bolt Pride family on this January 1st, 2017, thank you for helping out, supporting the cause. Let's contribute a little something. Two people are gonna walk away with these footballs today. Oh, it's a good thing it's in the plastic. DJ Will, DJ Tony Miranda, do your thing, baby, out!
Starting to fill up. The buzz is starting to come along, but it's still a little different. However, behind you guys, the Bolt Pride party is still lit, no matter what. So. All right, so this is gonna be a quick Q&A with my dad here. First question. I guess just basic info. How long you been a Chargers fan? How long you had season tickets for?
Okay, I started off going to Charger games. My mom and dad started taking us in the late 60s, early 70s. Later on, I had gone to some games in high school, okay, which was nice because San Diego Jack Murphy Stadium only sat 50,000 people. But there were still only like 30,000 because the Chargers weren't always good, but they always had a nice fan base. My buddies could pick me up. We'd drive up to San Diego from Hopeville, California, and we'd get tickets right there on Loge, and we'd have excellent seats. It was fabulous. And then my brother happened to get tickets in 1979, and that's when we started going, and I went to every game with him in Air Coryell until we went to 1986, and then I got season tickets of my own. So we've had them for 35 years. It's just a wonderful experience.
What are some of your best memories or just generally favorite times? What do you take to heart that like this is what I'll remember most from going to games?
going back to when we first started going to the games, Eric Coryell was just my brother and I. So basically the game was all it was about. There was no such thing as brunch. We just started tailgating. It was pretty cool, but the game was the focus because we didn't want to miss a minute of it. And then later on, we started doing more of the tailgating thing, and they had their down years. So it was kind of more the fun was the tailgating, and we suffered through a lot of seasons, but we still kept faith, and we still wanted to win, and it was still a good time because then it evolved when my family came in, and we had several people having season tickets, and it was very nice and a very nice experience. And then later on, when everybody either because of whatever reason dropped out, and it was just Derek and I, and we had a good time, and then we started going to Old Town, have a little breakfast, and then it was just enjoyable, just the two of us. So it was kind of a special time later on. And now later Tanya and Derek go to the games, and you know, I don't go anymore just because I think it's their time, it's their, you know, it's their team, and I think it's wonderful, and I think they have the same experience together, you know, that we did similarly. It was you know, just the two of us, and we appreciated the games, you know, probably much more.
So now here comes the nitty-gritty part. What are your thoughts on the Chargers moving to LA?
I'm really sad to even think that the Chargers would consider leaving San Diego, and I wish something would get done. They've been there so long. All the Bernerska, the blood drives, and everything they've done for the community. The Spanos family is involved in the community. I don't understand why they just don't want to stay there. Sunday will be very emotional. I hope there's some way that they will stay. If they leave, I'll always have it in my heart for them. I don't know that I would root for them or make efforts, because to me they belong in San Diego. That's bottom line.
And I don't know if you've heard about this, but there have been reports saying, rumored reports, saying that if the team were to move to LA, the Spanos family would consider a rebranding of the team. They were considering new team colors, new logos, like a complete rebrand of the team. What are your thoughts on that?
I mean, name. What about name?
Name too. New name. For example, Cleveland Browns moved to Baltimore,
right.
And the Baltimore Ravens.
Sure. Okay.
Something like that.
Here we go. No.
How do you feel about that?
Dean Spanos, so I would love it if you would change the logo, the name, the everything. Give San Diego back our team. We want the Chargers. The Chargers belong in San Diego. That's what we're all about. That's why you moved from L.A., or they moved from L.A. years ago in 1960, okay? Because San Diego supported them, and we supported them all the time, and they deserve. Cleveland Browns are the Cleveland Browns. All the other teams, Baltimore Colts, they lost their team. They should still be Baltimore. So San Diego, we need to be the Chargers.
So this is our last time walking up to the stadium from the car.
It's cold, kind of. Not for Derek.
It's kind of a weird feeling. Like it doesn't, like, it just feels like we're walking up the stadium, but like in my head I'm still thinking like this could be it, you know? It'll be interesting to see how this game pans out, what the thoughts and feelings are. For anyone who's familiar with any of the story, last year the Dolphins game, that felt like the last game ever. And we got another year. This game is more likely to be the last game ever, and I think everyone's already ready, like, and done and said goodbye. So I don't know what the feeling's gonna be like.
Turning around.
update. Chiefs are up 20-10. We got a second half to go still. Not too happy about certain ways that have gone. Few stragglers that are not leaving the stadium. There's chants of save our bolts, keep our bolts. There's expletives followed by the name Spanos happening. Amidst everything, as hard as this is, as much as it sucks, I think I feel the most for the older generation Charger fans. And Tanya and I were talking about it earlier. Like the ones who have been around for years, since like the 60s, 70s, 80s, like the team, they just stuck to their team all these years, you know. It's no secret the Chargers have never won a Super Bowl. And like, they've followed them as long as they have, just to have them possibly leave their city and just like that. That's the part that sucks the most. definitely the end of the game too. As I was mentioning last year, from the differences from the Dolphins game. Dolphins game last year, when it felt like it was goodbye, you had people staying for quite some time after the game, and Rivers and Gates and Weddle and people coming out signing out autographs. No one wanted to leave. This year they kind of just turned the lights off on us and said, get out. If you were in a room with Dean Spanos and you could say anything you wanted to say to him, what is it that you would say to him right now, at this very moment? He walks in the door and you can say whatever you want.
Whatever
you want.
I said, f*** you, Dean. So, no, I would say, Mr. Spanos, all due respect, I appreciated when your dad on the team better, because your dad seemed to care more about the community and about winning, okay? Alex Spanos started it all. He was the one that made it fun. And it seems like you've distanced yourself from all of the fans and the community since you've taken over.
Well said. All right, I think perfect. Thank you. Thank you very much. I appreciate it. Thanks, Dad.
All right.
Honey, does this place look familiar?
Yeah.
What's significant about this right here? What is significant about this location? So right here, Gate E, this is actually where Tanya and I had our first kiss. I mean, I look around the stadium and I just see a bunch of different memories, you know? Things that happened in games past. I mean, I don't know, honey. Can you imagine no stadium, no Chargers, no San Diego? I don't know. I don't know that I don't know. I just don't know. I mean, we find out in a month. When this video comes out, there may or may not be a decision. I hope they stay.
Yeah, me too.